Hello everyone, welcome to this next video on complex analysis. This video is from 2004 and the question is correspondingly of 2 marks. The question says, if W is equal to f of z be the given linear transformation that maps these corresponding points minus 1 to minus iota, 0 to plus 1 and then 1 to the point plus iota. So, these 3 points are mapped to these 3 points. Let us call them by z1, z2, z3 in the z plane and by w1, w2, w3 in the w plane. And if the transformation is defined like this, then they are asking what is the value of f of 1 minus iota. So, we have to determine this particular value. So, for that, we will use this formula, namely the cross ratio, right? So here we can substitute these 6 values as defined here. So what is z1? z1 is 1. And then we have z2 as 0 minus 1. And then z1 is minus 1 minus 0. And then we have z3 is 1 minus z. And similarly for w, we have w plus iota. And then we have w2 is 1 minus iota. Divided by w1 is, we have minus iota minus 1 and then w3 is iota minus w. So these are the values. So we can simplify them a little bit. So from here we get minus z plus 1 and from the denominator we have again this minus sign. So minus z minus 1. So this minus and this minus cancels. And from the right hand side, we had w plus iota and then we have 1 minus iota divided by, we can take this minus common from this term and we can multiply it over here. So we would have iota plus 1 as such. So this minus would thus make this term w minus iota, right? So this is the equation. Now in the question, they are asking what is the value of this f of 1 minus iota. So from here, what we can do, we can replace z with this quantity 1 minus iota and w with this quantity f of 1 minus iota. So let us do that. So it would be 1 minus iota plus 1 divided by 1 minus iota minus 1. So this is the left hand side. So from here you see this 1 and 1 cancels. Moreover, here on the right hand side we have f of 1 minus iota plus iota, this term multiplied by 1 minus iota, and then we have f of 1 minus iota minus iota and then multiplied with iota plus 1. So this is the term. So you can simplify this. So it would simply be 2 minus iota, right? And so you basically have minus 1 upon iota into 2 minus iota. So you can simplify this further. So you'll be having, 1 upon iota, this is equivalent to minus iota. Why? Because you can always multiply it by iota. So this iota square would be minus and then iota. So it would simply be 2 iota minus iota square, so that is plus 1. Minus iota square is plus 1. So this thing is equivalent to writing, this thing is same. So it would be f of 1 minus iota plus iota, right, multiplied by 1 minus iota, and then we can divide the by the same term, f of 1 minus iota multiplied by iota plus 1. So now we can shift these 2 factors on the left hand side. So we would have 2 iota plus 1 as such multiplied by this denominator term iota plus 1 divided by 1 minus iota. So this thing is equivalent to writing f of 1 minus iota plus iota divided by f of 1 minus iota minus iota. So this is the term. Now we can solve this thing. So when you simplify this, you'll be getting 3 iota minus 1 divided by 1 divided by iota minus 1. So you can check your calculation. So it would be f of 1 minus iota plus iota divided by f of 1 minus iota, right? And again, you can simplify this thing either by applying componendo or dividendo, or simply just solve for f of 1 minus x. You have to evaluate this thing. So when you solve this thing, you'll be having 4 iota minus 2 divided by 2 iota. This thing is equivalent to f of 1 minus iota upon iota. So from here, f of 1 minus iota comes out to be 2 iota minus 1. So this is our final solution. So here, the value of f of 1 minus iota comes out to be 2 iota minus 1. So from here, 2 iota minus 1, that means this option A is the correct option. Well, that is it for this video. Thank you for watching.